This is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to see how to install VMware Workstation. VMware Workstation installation. So we need to follow some steps to install VMware. First step, download VMware Workstation, and second one, download Linux. Here we are going to download CentOS, and we are going to see installation of CentOS in VMware Workstation. So we are going to see all these steps in this class. So first, let's start downloading VMware Workstation. Let's open any web browser. So open Google. Let's open Google. So search VMware Workstation. So it will takes you VMware website. Click on this VMware Workstation link. I am opening new link. Okay, so here you will see VMware Workstation link download location. So here you will see download option. VMware Workstation Pro. So here somewhere you will see VMware Workstation download option. This one downloads. Or let's open another link. Download VMware Workstation. I am trying to download this one. This is Pro download. So here you will see VMware Workstation Pro. So click on Workstation Pro and click on download. So it started downloading VMware Workstation Pro. Or you can go to File Hippo. This is one of the trusted software downloading website. So here you can search VMware Workstation Pro. So here you will see what VMware Workstation Pro download. Click on this one, it will start downloading latest version. Already we started what? Downloading from direct VMware Workstation, vmware.com, or we can download VMware from web, filehippo.com. You can use any one site, but better to go for vmware.com. Okay, so we downloaded VMware Workstation. Let's open folder downloaded location, show in folder. So you will see this one, right? VMware Workstation pull. Double click on this one. Installation of VMware Workstation is very easy. Installation of VMware Workstation is very easy. Just click on accept. It started installing VMware Workstation. Let's minimize. Let's see process here. So we are installing latest version. By default we get 30 days trial version. So you can use this workstation 30 days without paying any money to VMware company. Let's wait minute. So it started installing. So it's installing. Click on next and accept the license agreement and click on next and click on. So it is installing in program files, VMware workstation. Click on next and see, it's already some features are enabled. So if you want to check updates in startup, select this one. Otherwise, uncheck these two options and click on next, and it is creating shortcut in desktop and startup. Click on next, click on install. That's it. So it will start installing VMware workstation in your machine. So you understand how much simple it is to install VMware workstation, right? So once installation is successful, it will ask only one step. You will see what is that step. So this is completely installation process. After installation, we do some post installation steps. We will see what are those post installation steps. In post installation step, we do what? Registration process, registering key if you have. Otherwise, it will give you 30 days trial version. See, in desktop it is created one folder, right? Icon. Okay, so finally click on this finish button. That's it, installation is completed. Let's open VMware. Click on this VMware workstation icon. So here it is asking us to enter license key. If you have license key, enter this one, or if you want to use trial version, click on this I want to try VMware workstation 14 to 30 days. Let's click on continue. Yes, finish. That's it. So installation of VM workstation is very easy. You got it right? So we downloaded VMware workstation and we install workstation. Next, we are going to download CentOS and we are going to install CentOS in VMware workstation. Okay, see how to download CentOS. Let's go to open browser and open Google. Let's search CentOS download. CentOS 7 is the latest version. Click on CentOS 7 download. It will open centos.org/downloads. First link. Click on this first link. Here you will see three options: DVD ISO file, everything ISO file, minimum ISO file. You will see what? Three options. DVD, ISO file, everything ISO file, and next one, minimal ISO file. If you download minimal ISO file, you will see only after installation, you will see only terminal, Linux terminal. After installation, you will see only Linux terminal. If you download DVD and everything ISO file, you will see GUI part. You can install only minimal version, or you can install GUI versions. So this everything ISO and DVD ISO file contain both features. So you will see both GUI and CUI. You will see both GUI and CUI. The size of DVD ISO greater than 3 GB. The size of this DVD ISO is greater than 3 GB. Everything ISO is greater than 7.5 GB. So it contains multiple softwares in it. It contains important softwares. As a Java developer, as a normal developer, this DVD ISO file is enough. Okay. So let's click on this DVD ISO file. Here you will see different links for download. So these are nearest to your machine, and these are actual. You can click on any one. So I am going to click on first link. Click on this one. It will start downloading. I have already downloaded, so I am going to stop. It is going to take 12 minutes. So based on your internet speed, it will take time to download. Okay, let's stop here. I am cancelling. I have already downloaded in my machine. So it is presented in my machine. It is presented under E drive, under softwares. I have already sent OSs installed. Okay, so we saw how to download, right? Next step is installing CentOS in VMware workstation. How do we install? So here we do some steps. Pre-installation, first we follow some steps. Pre-installation and deinstallation, and third one, post installation. So this pre-installation, we do some steps in VMware. Let's do pre-installation steps. So we have already downloaded and installed VMware, right? We already opened VMware workstation. So first, if you want to install VMware workstation, here this is Explorer area. Right click here, click on new virtual machine, or click on file menu, click on new virtual machine. Both are same. So click on new virtual machine. Select typical is recommended. If you want to customize, you can choose customize, but recommended is typical. So leave as it is. Select typical, click on next. See here it's showing three options. If you have already DVD with ISO file, choose this option. If you have ISO file already downloaded in your machine, choose either this option, both are same. But I am choosing, I will install operating system later, okay? Next, click on next. Here, it's showing VMware supported operating systems list. It supports Windows, it supports Linux, it supports Novell Netware, it supports Solaris, it supports VMware ESXi server, and it supports others also. But I want to install Linux. In that Linux, it supports many flavors. You will see all Linux supported flavors. In this, we want what? CentOS, right? So CentOS 7, 64-bit. Click on next. Here, we give virtual machine name. So I am giving CNUTEC Linux. Then it will create VMware files in this location under users, under CNU technologies, under documents, under virtual machine, under CNU, this location. But I don't want to install VMware files in this location because C drive contain all bootable files. That's why I want to install in some other location. I'm going to select a different location by clicking on browse. So here I will install my operating system under E. Here what I'm doing, I'm creating one file. I'm selecting VMware. Under this VMware, I'm creating one file, one directory. So new directory. So CNUTEC Linux. I'm creating one directory, CNUTEC Linux. So choose this one, click on OK, and click on next. So here we will specify hard disk size. So minimum it requires 20 GB. Maximum you can take any size. Arjun, let's check what is the available size in my F drive, D drive, right? E drive. So this is my E drive. E drive size available, in E drive free space is available 146 GB. No problem. So I'm going to give 30 GB. You can give based on your requirement, give your hard disk size and click on next. And here you will see customize hardware. Let's click on this customize hardware. Here you will see by default it is allocated 1 GB RAM for this newly created operating system and one processor and network, one network adapter, sound drive, USB drive, printer, display. Okay, I want to allocate increase. If you want to increase RAM size, increase by dragging this. If you want to decrease, decrease by dragging. But I want to give 2 GB for this one. 1 GB is enough, but CentOS 7 takes more graphics, and that too we are going to use server with GUI. That's why I am going to allocate 2 GB. So allocate 2 GB. If you want to give number of processors, select number of processors. We have core i5, i7, like that processors in our machine, right? If you want to give number of processors, give number of processors. One processor is enough. So I am giving one processor only. And this is network adapter. So here you will see two options, NAT and bridge. What is NAT and what is bridge? If you use NAT operation, NAT network, so here if you install multiple operating systems in VMware, all operating systems contain NAT. It means only VM softwares can communicate each other. Outside this VM, it cannot communicate with Windows. If you want to make Windows also communicate with your operating system, click on bridge. Okay? And click on this DVD drive. Here, you choose ISO file. Click on this select ISO. We have downloaded ISO file, right? So go to that downloaded location by clicking on browse. So here I have downloaded under softwares. This is my CentOS 7. Select that ISO file. So whatever the location you downloaded ISO file, go to that location, select that ISO file, click on open. Okay, click on close, click on finish. So you will see here, see Nutec Linux. Here you will see power on this virtual machine. Or if you forgot to configure anything, click on edit virtual machine, you will see previous window. If you want increase RAM, select here. If you want to add one more processor, select this option. If you want to increase the hard disk size, or if you want to change ISO file location, you can modify all the option, click on OK. Then click on power on virtual machine. So this complete pre-installation steps are completed. Now we are going to do installation process. See, installation process starts when we click on power on this virtual machine. It will start installing virtual machine. Okay, so here you will see this option. Click on cursor here, click on up arrow, select the first option, press enter. So it started installing. To come out from this window, Control Alt. It come out cursor from this environment outside. So if you want to make full screen, this is the full screen option. Let's increase this one. So it started installing. Here we will do some steps. So click on language selection, continue. Here we select a date. Date is here, we select India. So it automatically select Kolkata. And here we'll select, this one is important, minimal or we want to install server with GUI. Click on done. Next, click on this installation destination. So it already selected. Just click on here. Again click. Click on done. Then here, click on this network and click on this on. It will automatically generate IP address for us. If you want to give host name, give here. Give CNUTEC. I am giving CNUTEC. .com. You can give any name. Click on apply. Okay, click on done. That's it. Click on begin installation. So here it will ask you your root password. I'm giving CNUTEC. You can give your own name. So click on done. If you want to create user, click on this user creation. I'm giving username is CNUTEC. And I'm making CNUTEC user as root administrator. And I'm giving password CNUTEC. You can give your own username and your own password. Okay, click on done. Done. So it started installing. It will take time. So it is going to install 1257 packages. It will take around 15 to 20 minutes. installation successfully completed. Now it started post installation steps. It will take a few minutes. Once post installation is successfully completed, then we start using Linux. So installation successfully completed. Click on reboot button. So it will reboot operating system, not our entire machine. It will reboot only Linux operating system. Okay. See. First time we will do some steps, and next two startups we cannot do all these steps. So it shows user login page, it shows list of users. If user is not presented in the showing list, you can click on other. So here we need to accept license. Click on this accept first time only. It will this window shows only first time. Click on accept license agreement, done. So here you will see finish configuration. So it's showing users list. If users list is not presented here, whatever the user you are expecting, click on not listed and enter username. I am entering root. Click on next and enter password. I have created password is Cenotech. Click on sign in. Okay. So first time it opens one more window. So this window, let's click on next. Click on next. Click on skip. That's it. Start using CentOS Linux. So close this one. That's it. So this is CentOS window. Okay. So if you want to hide this one, click on this button. So here, how do we open terminal? Right click here. Click on open terminal. Press ls. It will list all the files and directories. Okay, you got it right. How to install VMware workstation And on top of VMware workstation, we know how we install Linux operating system, right? Okay. If you want to shut down this machine, click on this power button. Click on this power button. It will ask if you want to restart, click on power on. Or one more way to power off this machine, minimize this one. Here you will see, right click on this one, click on power, and here you will see suspend. If you click on suspend option, instead of restart, operating system is in same state. So if you click on power off, it will shut down operating system. That's it. Click on power off. Okay. So thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe our channel, and please write your valuable comments. Thank you.